Are you ready for every chance to perform? Have you chosen the right tools, considered a plan of attack, and calmly taken your approach? Find out what Zowe version 3 can do for your site and your mainframe development performance. Let's hit on the hot topic straight out of the gate, Zowe V3. Can you tell us a little bit about it, Elliot, and why we should be excited about using it?
Absolutely. So hi, Zach, it's a pleasure to be here. Thank you for inviting me. So Zowe V3, it's out now for a couple of weeks or so. Okay. It's our third major release. So it's a very exciting time for the Zowe community, and we're really excited to see, you know, how it's gonna take off. So I think, we think of it in terms of evolution rather than revolution, okay. Right? So I think, you know, when you look back and you look, you know, we had our first release, you know, some years back now, and, you know, that was extremely exciting to see the uptake. Version 2 was introduced a bunch of new features, you know, really helped kind of stabilize the Zowe project. And then V3 a couple of weeks ago, I think is more evolution rather than revolution, I think, to coin a cliche. We think of it in terms of kind of three things. So I think, you know, first of all, we think of it in terms of greater sort of durability for the Zowe project.
Yes.
So what I mean by that is, you know, we really worked on the kind of foundational elements of some of the core components. So if you look at the API mediation layer, for example, mm-hmm. You know, we introduced the Spring Cloud Gateway that replaces our old Netflix Zool Gateway.
Okay.
So again, that's positioning us for, for a number of years going forward now in terms of having like an actively maintained and developed gateway there at the core of the mediation layer. And then, you know, another example I can give you would be on the Zowe desktop. So we updated a number of the libraries, including Angular there. Again, you know, this is all with a view to positioning us for the future.
It's a stronger foundation.
Yeah, exactly. So that's kind of on the durability side. And then, you know, the second element of three that we think of in terms of this release, I guess, would be around sort of stability. Our user base has been telling us for a little while that, you know, it could be easier to install and configure.
Yes.
Zowe, right? And we hear them, we've spoken to them. And so, you know, we've introduced with V3 a new install wizard.
Okay.
Right, which is going to help you kind of guide you through some of the key install steps, configuration steps. And, you know, the other thing we've done is we've removed Node.js from the entire configuration process. So it means you no longer need Node.js when you configure the mediation layer, which removes a little layer of complexity.
Definitely. Makes things faster, too.
Faster, yes. Right. Exactly. So that's durability, stability, and then the third thing, which is kind of, you know, the bit we like to talk about, because it's the bit where we introduce some cool stuff to the release.
Of course.
So we already have an explorer for VS Code, Zowe Explorer, and we've now introduced one for IntelliJ.
Okay.
So if you're an IntelliJ user out there, you know, you're looking to access the mainframe through your, you know, IDE of choice, you can now do that through IntelliJ. So that's pretty exciting. And then a couple of SDKs as well that we've introduced. So, you know, if you have a Kotlin or Java application that accesses the mainframe, or you're planning to build one, so we now have a couple of Zowe, you know, fully open source SDKs that you can pick up that's going to make that interaction from your Kotlin or Java application much, much easier into the mainframe. And those are in addition to the already existing Node and Python SDKs that we already have available.
That's super. So it's going to be much easier for folks to integrate with the Zowe ecosystem using things which have already kind of building blocks which are already put together for them.
Absolutely, absolutely. I mean, we're all about kind of open integrations, you know, outside of the platform. So this is just, you know, sort of more proof of that kind of philosophy that we have.
Excellent. So yeah, that third point, especially the new features, that's always the exciting part about a major release. But it's great to hear about the stability, and also, I mean, simply making it an easier install. I know that from our customers as well, because we recommend all the Zowe things, that they often point out that it's been kind of a difficult journey to get everything set up, API, ML. So to hear that there's an installer and it's more straightforward on the configuration side, yeah, that's excellent.
And we will continue to work on that, right? So we have this install wizard, but you know, we're not stopping there. So there's going to be improvements going into the wizard itself as we go through the kind of V3 life cycle, but also, you know, we'll continue to work on improving that experience outside of the wizard as well.
That's excellent. Now let's step back a little bit. So this is Elliot Jalley. He's in product management here at Broadcom. He's been with the Zowe project since the beginning. So let's provide a little more general context around Zowe for the folks that may not know much about it or have heard about it, but haven't yet taken a step in that direction. So can you give us a little story of the genesis of the project?
Sure.
and where we are today?
Sure, yeah. So I'm Elliot Jalley. I'm a product manager here at the Prague R&D Center at Broadcom. And I've been involved, I'm a Zowe ambassador, and I've been involved with Zowe since its inception, about 6 years ago now.
Okay.
And, you know, really, you know, when you think about Zowe, so what it offers are a set of modern interfaces to the mainframe.
Yes.
So, you know, we consider it as, you know, a really important tool in your modernization toolbox, right, as an organization. So if you as an organization are, you know, looking at the technology that you've invested in to run your business, you know, you want it to be, cost effective, performant, you want it to, you know, help in terms of sort of operational aspects. And you know, you want to be able to hire, you know, the best new talent out there as well. You don't want your technology to be a blocker to that in any way, shape, or form.
Well, and another aspect too is I think you want to have a sense that you're going in a direction that other people are as well. And the great thing about Zowe as an open source project is there are a lot of contributions coming in from different vendors and different sites to really build this up, because everybody's realizing that they want to modernize, they need to attract the new talent using new tools, but they also want to all kind of provide to the same kind of workflows and know that these things work.
Absolutely, absolutely. So I think, you know, I think where Zowe really provides a huge amount of value, and why I said earlier that it's probably your main tool in your kind of modernization toolbox, is, you know, there's a number of aspects here, but, you know, certainly in terms of kind of offering greater automation capabilities, right? I mean, that's a given. So a lot of, you know, a lot of when people talk about modernization, they talk about converting, you know, manual processes that are costly into automated processes, and Zowe has, you know, a whole range of tools that can help you do that. So that's one aspect in terms of automation, and the next word is a tough one to say. I'm going to give it a shot. Interoperability.
Yes.
So what that means is, you know, the ability to communicate across platforms. So, you know, again, Zowe offers these different tools and interfaces to allow you to actually integrate to other platforms and just be another part of your IT stack and not something separate on the side. So that's the second sort of area where Zowe really helps. And the third and final one that I'll mention for now is around skills and hiring the best talent out there. If you think of yourself, if you're a student that's been through 5 years of university studying coding, So you've studied, you know, how to code different languages, how to script, how to test your application, all those kind of things. And you've been doing it maybe through VS Code, you've been doing it maybe on IntelliJ, and then you go out, you've got your degree, you go out and, you know, you're getting offers from mainframe shops, and, you know, you're suddenly confronted with a range of interfaces and tools that are totally alien to you.
Yes. You know, feel like you get put in a box.
You might have read about them somewhere, you know, like in a kind of a history textbook or something like that. But basically, you know, you know that can be daunting, and that can put you off a career in the mainframe, which is a shame because, you know, obviously, you know, the mainframe, it's an incredible community of people, and, you know, there is cutting edge technology in the mainframe, right? So. So where Zowe helps is, you know, again, coming back to those modern interfaces. So it allows you to talk to the mainframe through VS Code, if that's your preferred IDE, now through IntelliJ, right?
Yes, with exactly. V3.
So if you like using Git, you know, for version control, again, you know, a topic that's close to your heart, right?
Yes, indeed.
So you can, you know, you can do that. You can absolutely go, and the beauty of it is as well, is that you can do that alongside colleagues in your team who maybe prefer to go through the older interfaces, and that's absolutely fine. And
exactly.
You can achieve the same things, you have the same objective, but you're doing it through a set of modern interfaces, whereas your colleagues maybe prefer to use a 3270, you know, and that's absolutely okay. That's absolutely fine.
Definitely. And in these three phases, I mean, if we kind of pair Zowe components with the automation, a common starting point for everyone is using CLI. And so we have CLI plugins for core products and CLI, I mean, not just our products, but also IBM and elsewhere. And then from the interoperability, obviously this is, you can say the APIML is probably the center point of this, which we'll touch on a little bit more. And then you already covered kind of the VS Code, the IDEs, VS Code, IntelliJ, and especially the Zowe Explorer.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
So that's a great overview of Zowe. And I do want to home in on that interoperability, because I know you've worked especially on Zowe API mediation layer. And when we talk about the mediation layer, that's kind of an access point, a single point to access various APIs, right? While that, I think, has a great story around it, and a number of people are using it, especially for kind of the authentication value that it brings and being able to use certificates and things like that, there's been kind of a general question about APIs and opening up products. And I understand that we're kind of going in the direction of trying to help customers understand what's available. So can you talk to us about this integration catalog and how that connects to these things?
Sure. So APIs is a subject that's close to my heart. APIs specifically for the mainframe. So I think, you know, where I always start on this topic is APIs are absolutely foundational to Zowe.
Yes.
So from the beginning, you know, here at Broadcom, we've been really focused on producing on what we call API enabling, you know, our solutions. So producing, you know, REST APIs, you know, for all of our major solutions.
Yes.
So that our customers, you know, have that capability, so that they can pick up these REST APIs and, you know, access the mainframe in different ways than what was possible before. So that's, you know, that again, that's foundational. And, you know, I think you look across all of our solutions and pretty much, you know, you're going to find a Zowe conformant REST API. And if there isn't one, I guarantee there'll be one.
It's on the roadmap. Yep.
It's on the roadmap. the mediation layer comes into the picture in the sense that, if you look at modernization, if you acknowledge the role that APIs are going to play in that ecosystem, then, you know, clearly what we're seeing is a proliferation of APIs. And, you know, where you have that, it's beneficial to have a component that actually, you know, manages and secures those APIs within your organization.
Yes.
And that's where the mediation layer comes in. I heard, you know, my friend and fellow Zowe ambassador, Joe Winchester, refer to the mediation layer as a telephone switchboard in some sense. It's an analogy I like and both dislike.
Of course. So
I like it in the sense that I think it illustrates an easy way to understand the fact that, you know, there are folks calling in to the mainframe through these APIs. It's coming into the mediation layer, and then the mediation layer is then routing that call to wherever they're going, right? So if they're looking for environment information through SysView, if they're looking for sort of DB2 automation, so the mediation layer helps you and routes in a secure fashion, you know, these calls coming through. So it's a nice analogy in that sense. What I don't like about it is the sense that, you know, we're talking about cutting edge technology in the mediation.
We have to go back in time.
Telephone switchboard isn't quite that, but nevertheless, I think it helps illustrate the value of the mediation layer. So that's the mediation layer. And then, you know, you had mentioned the integration portal.
Yeah.
So that's something that, you know, we've been working on as a kind of a supporting resource for our Broadcom customers. We wanted a way to really showcase the wealth of endpoints that we have available out there across all our solutions. And while we were documenting that previously, it was kind of...
It was all in different places.
So we thought, right, you know, let's just make this much easier for our customers to actually, you know, discover, explore and experiment with our APIs. And so that was really the objective of the integration portal. Let's pull all of this documentation together and just allow folks to, you know, see what's available, go into a particular API, have a look at the Swagger documentation, see some of the, you know, requests and responses available, and just really get a good understanding of what's out there and what's available and what they can do with that API. Because not only is it about the technical documentation, you know, we also want to speak about potential use cases for those APIs as well.
Certainly, because really that can be an entry point actually if they're considering any of the Zowe stuff really. What APIs do I have available? And then, okay, do I have CLI plugins that I want to access those? Do I want to take the next step and set up API mediation layer because I realize there's a lot of value in accessing those and I want that secure point mm-hmm. of entry? Mm-hmm. And obviously, accessing the CLI is also achievable from the IDEs. So it's really understand what you have, what value there could be, and then you can look at the various Zowe components and how they can connect to them.
100%, 100%. And what I didn't say, which I just want to kind of stress now on the portal, is how you can access it, right?
Yeah. Of course.
So, you know, where do you find it? So it's a publicly available website.
Okay.
Right? So anyone can access it. So if you go to our mainframe Broadcom site, you'll find it there in a drop-down menu. There's also a URL which we might point to.
I think we'll put it at the end of this video.
Let's do that. So
go here.
Yeah. So so you can go there directly as well. So and again, it's accessible to anyone. You can go and have a look at that today if you wanted to.
That's excellent. Elliot, it's been great having you. Great to hear kind of the genesis of Zowe. Obviously, Zowe V3, that's the great new thing. Go check it out. And now this integration portal as well. Check it out to understand the values you get from APIs and then the subsequent value you can get from using the various Zowe components.
It's been a great pleasure. Thanks so much, Zach.
Thanks, Elliot. Elliot, I hear you're a great pool player. Let's have a game.
Sure, let's do it. Thanks for the game, Zach.